It's now been late. But if you want another, as the plate proceeds, we beg you please to eat it with the wrapper on. Thank you.
Thus it came to pass on a moonless night on February 9th, 1964, a semi-professional harmony group, Forever Plaid, received their calling to perform their first big gig in a little town in western Pennsylvania. Having no map but trusting in the constant glow of the North Star, they were faithfully forging through the Pennsylvania countryside when they were slammed broadside by a school bus filled with eager Catholic teens from Our Lady of Harrisburg. The teens were on their way to see the Beatles make their U.S. television debut on the Ed Sullivan Show and sustained no injuries. Our lads in plaid, however, were killed instantly. They were allowed to come back to Earth for one night to do the show they never got to do in life. Having performed their show, they returned to the heavenly cosmos as guardians of harmony for all eternity. They were never to return to Earth again. Or were they? Oh.
Nothing, we just, you know, we sing.
Cool.
We can't just sing. Every show must have an arc, a thrust, a through line, a denouement, a moon. Not to mention metaphoric imagery and literary symbolism. A reason to sing, a higher purpose.
Well, maybe our purpose is to simply figure out our purpose. The question is the answer.
Like in the works of the existential artists like Beckett, Sartre, and Jerry Lewis.
Hey, my husband's come back.
I think I'm getting a nosebleed again.
My ulcer's acting up again.
I'm nervous.
I'm panicked.
I'm rolling over in my grave right now. I'm leaving.
Smudge, come back here.
No.
Come back here.
No. We'll sing the songs we practiced last time but didn't get to do.
We never practice with our bodies. We only practice in our mind's eye as amorphous blobs of ectoplasmic ephemera.
Just follow me if you get lost.
Yeah, come on, come on. We can make the biggest comeback since Capri Pants.
Why has this posthumous guy group been jettisoned back to Earth? Parapsychologists believe that when the angry, jagged frustrations of the human condition reach a feverish pitch, a heavenly SOS is sent to the spirit world. This channels Galahads of harmony through the dimensions to restore the Earth's hormonal balance. Ladies and gentlemen, that moment draws near.
If I stand starry-eyed, that's a danger in me.
question.
Won't you answer the fervent prayer of the stranger in paradise? Don't leave me in dark despair from all that I hunger for. But open your angel arms to the stranger in paradise and tell him that he
What should we do next?
I can't think. I got that warm and mushy feeling when we just sang.
I told you to go before we left.
I had too. Warm and fuzzy and comforted.
Wait, I sense something very suspicious in the air. Perhaps it's a clue. It's a tingling friskiness.
A clinging neediness.
A desire for selfless giving.
And shopping.
Ooh.
Well, I think that's what... love is supposed to feel like.
Do they look like they're in need of love?
They do have that shallow, empty, forlorn, regretful self-involvement. Maybe our mission is to instill love through music.
We know one love song.
No. It's too early in the show for mushy love ballads. They tend to slow the pace and sadness operate precise the audience.
Well, not all love songs have to drag. Lots of love songs are hip, or even hip.
We're not hip or hip.
Yeah, but our sunglasses are. Guys, got your sunglasses.
Jinx!
No!
I brought a brand new pair for you, Jinx.
Jay.
Okay, let's pick up the tempo and swing a Hosanna too.
Love more.
Swing high, sing hallelujah. Swing low, sing hallelujah. My heart is all aglow, and now I really know. Hallelujah, I just love that song. Amor, amor, amor.
This word so sweet that I repeat, and I adore you.
Had when we were alive.
We're just a bunch of sad sacks.
scared, misguided, desperate,
depressed, dejected, dyslexic.
Wait! I bet our mission lies in the nostalgia of all those devastating memories. We're here to show other aimless souls that even though our lives were miserable, hopeless, forlorn, pathetic, we can overcome the shackles of our past, creating a harmonic convergence, and thus find our reason for being. Or as the French would say, our raison d'être.
Everyone in soulful reminiscence of one shared experience.
Like in a normal concert, that's when the singing stars would sing a medley of their hits.
Oh,
yeah.
But we didn't have any hits.
But we had a show.
Maybe the answer to our conundrum is hidden in our previous musical endeavors.
Oh, is there anyone out there who saw us before during our last extraterrestrial outing?
Oh, yes, all of
thank you!
And for how many of you is this your first plaid experience?
Ah, plaid virgins. Ah, it's okay, don't be ashamed, be proud. You've come at the right time.
Thanks, Mark.
So that none of you feel left out, we'll do a summation of the highlights of our former visit.
Like a recap.
Well, like the cliff notes.
It's like daytime television.
Previously, in Forever Plaid. As the cummerbund turns, the plaids of our lives.
The age of plaid!
Dark plaidos.
Are you through?
The young and the plaidless.
Okay, now I'm through.
described how we met there, Como.
A flash of light, a thunderclap, our tuxes came.
Just said that and then our big finale, but we didn't want to go. We didn't know that we'd return so soon.
So we went back reluctantly. We wanted to stay. That was our show, and now we're back. And if we get through this show, we'll all have moments to remember. If we get through this show, you'll have moments to remember. If we get through this, when other nights and other days may find us gone our separate ways, we will have these moments to remember. We will have these moments to
never done.
Sing on pitch?
We must boldly face a new challenge that we've never faced, and by overcoming it, we shall prove our plaid worthiness.
Oh no, the choreography is too treacherous. Couldn't we?
I don't know, I'll ask.
Ladies and gentlemen, there was this number that we were hoping to add to our repertoire that we never got to perform with real microphones. So, with your permission, we feel a lot more comfortable if we can premiere it the way we rehearsed it.
In the stock room of my family's plumbing supply company.
Using these plumber's helpers as microphones. Is that alright with you?
Sometimes they fall over.
Is this thing on?
So listen closely.
Row, row, row your boat
gently down the stream. Merrily, 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 merrily.
Life could be a dream. And I'm a ding dong, lay, 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 bum, ba, doo.
If I could take you up in paradise above, if you would tell me I'm the only one to love,
shouldn't
she a dream, sweetheart?
Hello, hello again, shouldn't we so we may meet again?
Shouldn't we be a dream?
If only all my precious plans would come true. If you would let me spend my whole life loving you, life could be a dream, sweetheart.
Every time I look at you,
shaboom. Dee-doo-dee-doo, shaboom, shaboom, sweetheart.
Comforted and warm and runny on the inside.
side. Anyways, that was the Uber Dream, the driving force. Right under the Uber Dream was the Under Dream, coming from the German word under, meaning under. Now, the Under Dream had to be real specific in order to make the Uber Dream come true. So we all decided that the way to get people that comforted and warm and ready feeling was by creating our own TV holiday special. See, my parents were separated. The only time we were all together was at Christmas. The only time we were together and not yelling was when we were watching TV. So, every year during Harry Como, Dean Martin, and Milton Berle's Christmas special, Mom or Dad would get decked up into the Santa Claus suit. And during the annual Santa Claus sketch, they would act it out for us, live, just on the side of the Zenith. Well, then we'd pass around empty gift boxes pretending that they were presents, and then Mom and Dad would go home to their other families. See, we the Plaids knew the soothing effects that holiday programming could bring, so we all decided on the same dream. We made a model of what our Christmas set would look like. Oh, excuse me. See? It's our ideal holiday home. Stocked with windows, a fireplace with stockings hung with care, Christmas trees, presents. Well, we would be here, and the audience would be there. And here's the snow. Whenever we would get sad or low about our lives, we would all gather in my basement and sing Christmas carols. Well, even in August. When we made the model, we would think about our dreams. We would all gather together and sing. Lock them in.
It's the most wonderful time of the year. There'll be much mistletoe and hearts will be glowing when loved ones are near. It's the most wonderful time. Merry Christmas. Have a very, very merry Christmas. Dream about your heart's desire. Christmas Eve, when you retire, Santa Claus and I know he'll draw exactly what you wanted down your chimney top. So be jolly, have a holiday that's gay as holly. May the ones you love be near you, and the laugh friends that cheer you when the church bells ring, like the angels sing, and you hear the joyful hymn they chant. Hey, a wish from me on your Christmas tree for a very merry Christmas time. Thank you.
so much. So much music is devoted to the lost Amore. And Amore left unrequited. Although none of us had an intimate relationship when we were alive, we beg you not to be like us. Be bold. Summon your courage for the one, well, the one you like, and say, Besame mucho. Each time I cling to your kiss, I hear music divine. Besame mucho. Hold me, my darling, and say that you'll always be.
Hey, guys, look!
glass quick. It's from Rosemary Clooney. I love her.
Oh, me too.
Hiya, Plads.
Hi, Rosie.
Nobody up here is supposed to be giving you guys down there clues, but me and my swinging cronies had a powwow, and we decided that we have any singers have got to help each other out. Right, fellas?
Right, Rosie.
Hurry, keep reading.
So I gotta clue you quick before the heavenly head cheese gets back. So pay attention, Plads. You return to Earth for just one reason. To spread your mirth in this cool season. Your clue is a festive song of celebration, the heritage of joy for each generation. Okay, so celebrations have dancing and drinking.
Heritage, Rosie was Irish.
And German.
Yeah, but everyone thought of her as Italian.
Okay, a Rosie tune that's filled with Italian dancing and festivities.
Thank you.
answers to clues in a Jack Frost way before the pearly gate shuts. Think of Nat King Cole and Mel Torme and of their roasting nuts!
I know it is! Here, oh my God, hold on first!
Vibrations of exhaustion mixed with anticipation.
Well, that can only mean one thing.
Ah, it's the holiday season!
Maybe that's why we came back, to do our holiday show.
That's it, I knew it, that was it! We don't have a holiday show!
Well, we could just yell Christmas at the end of every night.
I love that. Or we could leave now and forget the whole thing.
No. No!
Ladies and gentlemen, we'll try to adapt our show for you and your holiday needs.
Yes, you see, we're well-versed in music for all occasions.
No matter what our work was by day.
Well, I was in bathroom fixtures.
Dental supplies.
Auto parts.
Better dresses.
At nights and on weekends, we became forever plaid. Our business card. We'll serenade your every affair this holiday season.
If we're still around, we'd love to serenade your holiday galas, balls, and other private functions.
Christmas parties!
Oh, we can be in town.
Italian Christmas!
Oh, la, 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 la.
Feliz Navidad, Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Christmas!
Irish Christmas.
The holy Greek, the highly Greek, the greatest fishing in hell to see. It's Christmas in Killarney, with all the folks at home. Christmas!
And now, for our brother and sister in another Jewish faith, this comic of classic.
Merry Christmas from Jamaica, holy night.
said enough.
Matilda, who would have a trunk up? Matilda, who would have a trunk up? Matilda, she can't be bought in and go to the shopping.
Just a whisper. Matilda,
Matilda. Okay, it's a little loud, Senorita.
Matilda, she can't be bought in and go to the shopping.
Now, just think about it.
Yeah, we're gonna go and prepare a proper holiday show for you folks.
Matilda,
that was our mission.
Matilda,
taking intermission.
Matilda, she takes a break now and
having intermission.
Come on, take a break now.
Some fruit for me.
A Christmas show we'll make now.
Now it's intermission.
Thank you.
this board over here? Is this the lights?
Yes, sir. This is lights right here.
You're doing a great job.
Thank you, sir.
Has Ernell and you or just like nailed it?
Yes, me and Ernell, we do the mics and sound.
I'm Leo.
Hi, Lamar.
Lamar?
Lamar.
Lamar?
Yeah.
That's great job, Lamar.
Me.
Can I get back and meet any of these guys? Can I get back here and meet any of these guys?
Yeah, they come up after the play, they come up here and we can talk to them.
Oh, good, good.
Yeah.
I love to do that. Man.
Yeah, they come up after they finish. When I'm getting elevated.
You don't have too many people down here today, right?
No, it's not today. They'll be upstairs once. As soon as they finish taking the clothes, they'll be upstairs.
So good. These are the guys. These ones are white. My sweetheart here. You want to know how to run the lights? Look at all these people.
Yeah, that's a lot to go through.
Yeah, but it's perfect what you're doing. You guys are doing that mason board. What's this thing over here? Computer?
iPad.
Is that have to do with this thing?
Oh, no, that's just
no,
personal.
It's just,
something
just,
to play
just
with.
Yeah. Just to pass the time.
Thank you. You're doing a good job.
Nice place, Michael.
Nice place.
Oh, nah, stretch out.
We both need to get some
steel talkers here. You said, Rick really needs some help.
Dog, man.
What am I doing? I'm not going to let you buy him a couch. You can come here and make his money. Man, Rick really needs some help. We just gave him some help.
You must this motherfucking knee.
Think I'm gonna do it again. Wrong.
Y'all go in back.
It's gonna get you nasty.
We got the chrome running board. Don't do like James with the running board to put the turtle back. I'll be trying to climb up with that dog.
Here's Mr. Jim Parker. She just tells us she's been 12 years in New York.
Baby. It's on the, up on the counter.
your jeans. Check your reindeer dance steps.
Okay, turn, turn, turn. Step on change, step on change. Sausage, sausage, bring some lamb.
Atmosphere.
Yeah, it took a licking and kept on ticking. Come on, let's go.
We just couldn't find the words to say.
We ran out of words.
Just how could we find this holiday?
It really is well.
Our vocabulary had to grow.
We had to expand.
Excuse.
alone, saying a tenor's making the playful statement, which creates a symbolic alliance with those who are alone in a garden in the cold night. Their only recourse. They only included him for his nose. He was an inspiration. He let go of his hurt and need for revenge. He stayed focused on the bigger picture. He said, sure, I'll be your headlights. I'll be your high beams. Or low beams. You're supposed to use low beams in heavy fog. I never understood that, no matter how many times I watched that movie. Where was I? So my point is, I could never do what Rudolph did. Well, he was so selfless. And he was indeed welcomed by the majority. But there's a bittersweetness to his final acceptance. Because after that night, he became a beacon, a star. Oh, he was still alone. He stuck out when no one liked him. And he stuck out when he was a hero. He would never blend in. He would never be truly happy. Sorry. If I could just think of another Christmas song to sing that I didn't have issues with, I could stop talking.
Was the night full of jello.
Thank you. excitement at the chance to actually see Perry, or even his car, or even his chauffeur, or even his treadmarks. As if that didn't stir our kilts, Jinx had gotten his tongue frozen to a stop sign and had lingual frostbite. He couldn't pronounce any consonants.
I will.
Sparky.
It was almost showtime. There we were backstage at the Knights of Columbus Calf Gymnatorium. As we peered through the crushed velveteen curtains, we were inspired by the splendiferous table settings lovingly provided by Bethlehem's gourmet shop, Cheeses of Nazareth. As the lights dimmed, outside of the service entrance backstage, we heard a crash. Perry Como's Fleetwood limo had skidded into our cherry red 54 Mercury convertible. Yeah, this was great. Now we would have to see it, at least in court.
Yeah.
He had to wait inside for alternate transportation. He was forced to watch our show, but wait, it gets even better. His backup singers were stranded over 200 miles away in a near fatal collision. The lights dimmed. The curtain rose. We froze for a second. It wasn't stage fright, we were just cold. The lights hit us. To our surprise, the show was going great!
Hooks say a three-violet stand in the lane, so is his hand. A beautiful sight we're having tonight. Mumbo in the winter wonderland. Hook gone away.
I knew I had to seize fate by the maracas.
Mr. Combo, I said,
we realize that you don't have your backup singers for your Christmas special tomorrow. And we know that nothing should silence the true voice of Christmas, which we believe that yours is. I mean, there are others that think Bing Crosby is, but he has that one song, and you are a tradition.
So we are available to be of service to you in any position you like. And please, don't consider it an imposition. We know every song and arrangement that you ever did. It's always been our dream to sing with you. I don't mean to put you on the spot. But a plan's gotta do what a plan's gotta do.
Yeah.
So sit back, relax, and enjoy some of your favorite backup vocals. The backup vocal lines to Catch a Falling Star.
Bum, 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 bum. Bum ba bum 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 ba bum 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 ba bum 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 ba bum 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 ba bum
round and round
bum 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 bum
the little drummer boy looked at us with the expression of dogs when they've been given a command they haven't learned yet. We were mortified. And then Mr. Como stood up and in a voice of resonant yet understated compassion said he'd be honored if we would sing with him. Well, we thought we'd died and gone to heaven, but that came much later. The next day, a miraculous thaw occurred, melting all the snow. Paris singers arrived. All was well. And our services were no longer required. So after checking out of the Inn of Bethlehem, we were checking out the damage to our Merc. And lovingly taking pictures of Perry's skid marks. When Perry Como drove up in a tow truck, stepped down and gave us his Christmas card.
We wish you a Perry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. Oh, little town of Bethlehem, PA.
And since we never got to sing with Perry, thanks to our involvement with the audio and visual department, we'd like to sing backup for him now.
Can hardly wait for the world to start again.
Sunday before Christmas on CBS.
8 p.m.
7 Central and Mountain.
What's the Ed Sullivan Show?
And so, the Columbia Broadcasting System asks you to stay tuned for...
The Ed Sullivan Show! Brought to you by the Lincoln Mercury Division of the Ford Motor Company. Introducing the all-new Lincoln Capri. Leading the way in luxury driving. The new Capri by Lincoln proves that luxury can be fun. Pick one up for the missus this holiday season.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, for your holiday delectation, the entire Ed Sullivan Christmas Shoe in 3 minutes and 11 seconds.
Ready, Jinx?
Uh-huh.
5, 4, 3, 2.
Very good, Platt. Now listen up, turn around, and watch your head. You're going on the air.
Oh, the NBC Peacock.
Stand by in 5, 4, 3, 2. Live from the prizery, it's Platt Tidings.
Me too.
Well, it's the one wish we can't have.
It's the only wish that means anything.
Come on, we're so close to completing our mission. We're at the end. If we don't finish the show, everything we meant to do will have no meaning. And us having meaning is all that we have that means anything. I mean, it means so much to us to admit something.
Okay, yeah, you know, we get it.
We have to be grateful for the time we've had. We got to sing.
Oh, yeah.
We got to do our holiday show.
Yeah, I know.
You know why it's so difficult to leave?
Well, it hurts going through that white tunnel.
Well, that too. But what hurts even more is that we don't know if anyone will remember that when cruddy stuff happens in life, or even death for that matter, that we all have the ability to create a little harmony.
Aww. We better get out of here before you get any more mushy.
Yeah, you don't know any more songs anyway.
Oh, except for the closing of the trees. Hey, you guys. Maybe they'll bring us back to help people celebrate other holidays.
Like an Easter Christmas specials.
Or Valentine's Day.
The 4th of July.
Flag Day. Arbor Day.
Hey, it's so fun.
Secretary's Week.
Tuesdays.
Let's sing the last song. Go on the flag.
Thank you.